Christian friends.
Yes.
I already text you about sorry, I'm a Christian, but I have a friend to tell that if the can you go to the story of Waraqah and Khadija?
Okay. What about it?
And then if there is a sentence like Waraqah didn't finish yet about the his writing.
I understand what?
So when Waraqah died.
Yeah.
When Waraqah died, he has not finished yet, right?
Yeah.
So what the source Muhammad took gospel and Torah.
All right. I would answer, my friend. That's all?
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Yeah, that's all.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you a lot.
This is the hadith in front of us, Sahih al-Bukhari, and we show the reference so people will not say we are making things up. Hadith number 6982. Book number 91, according to the reference. You will see here that the first one who introduced Muhammad to God is Waraqah. The first one who said to Muhammad, you are a prophet, is Waraqah. The first one who was able to understand what the angel said to Muhammad is Waraqah. Waraqah is the founder of Islam, not Muhammad. You will see here that when Muhammad, he went to the cave and the angel came and he squeezed him 3 times. We go from the beginning of the story because the story is really funny and proving to us Muhammad to be a false prophet. So the prophet, he used to go to the cave, and one day when he was there, the angel came to him and asked him to read. The prophet replied, I do not know how to read. The prophet added, and now the prophet is telling the story to Waraqah, or to Khadija, sorry. The prophet added, the angel cut me forcefully, he squeezed him so hard, and pressed me so hard, and I could not bear it anymore, which means the guy almost died. Then he released me, and he said to me, read. I replied, I do not know how to read. Whereupon the angel cut me again, and he pressed me, squeezed me again, until I could not bear it no more. And then he released me, and he asked me to read. And I replied again, I do not know how to read. Here the story is proving to us that Muhammad from the beginning is a false prophet and Allah does not exist. Why? If Allah do not know that Muhammad do not know how to read, that means Allah is a false God. If Allah knows that Muhammad know not how to read, which means he knew that this guy cannot read, and he said to him, read, that means Allah is stupid. If Allah saying to Muhammad, read, and he knew that Muhammad, you do not know how to read, the only solution for this that Allah was making a miracle, like Jesus said to the blind man, see, so he saw. Otherwise, what the point of saying to him, see, and the guy is blind? Jesus, when he said to the one who cannot walk, carry your bed and run, he said to the guy first that he forgive his sin. The Jews, they were wondering, like, how the Messiah can forgive sin, who he think he is. So the Messiah, he said to them, what is easier for you to say, for me to say, your sin is forgiven, or to say to him, carry your bed and run and walk? And the guy who cannot walk all his life, he walk. Here we notice that Allah, he said to Muhammad 3 times, read. And remember, the read here is an order from Allah. The angel is just saying what Allah said. This is not the word of Allah. This is why this verse exists in the Quran. Remember, the Quran, the Muslims agree that everything in the Quran is Allah saying things. So the one is talking here is Allah. But the one is delivering the order is the angel. So if Allah said to Muhammad, read 3 times, and the Muslims, they claim that Muhammad cannot read. And the story in front of us confirmed that Muhammad supposedly cannot read. What kind of God, he said to a man, read, he cannot read. Trust me, the true God, even if he said to a donkey, read, the donkey will be able to read in all languages. So from the beginning, the story is stupid. Then, three times repeating the same question, three times he's squeezing him, which is very funny. Why you are squeezing a guy? He just told you, I can't read. What the point of the squeezing? Squeezing first time, second time, third time, to do what? What the angel accomplished from squeezing Muhammad three times? Muhammad don't understand. The angel was not able to convince him to read, and he was not able to read. So what the point of this? Stupid. Then the story continue. Thereupon he cut me again, third time, three time, Trinity. Islam established by the number three. Muhammad was activated by three squeezing, not by one squeezing. And here we have a question. Why Islam is stuck with the Trinity when Islam rejected Trinity? Why the angel cannot say to him, read once? Muhammad, when he interplays, he says, Assalamu alaikum, three times. Muhammad, he pray, he repeat the dua three times. Muhammad, he take an oath, he repeat the oath three times. Muhammad, he says, Adam won the debate, he repeat the same word, won the debate three times. Muhammad, he wanna go to the bathroom, he have to shake his penis three times. Muhammad, he wanna use stones to clean his ass, he have to use three rocks. Muhammad, he wanna do ablution, he have to wash his hand three times, his face three times, his nose, blah, 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 three times, everything is three times. A woman, she is divorced from her husband. If he divorce her three times, that's final. You take an oath on Islam, you have to say it three times. I mean, what is left? The whole cult is based on three times. Yet they are against, they are anti-Trinity. Then we continue here. After what this happened, the angel, he told him, read, and he continued, read in the name of your Lord, who created you, etc., and exist, blah, 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 blah. Then you will see from the beginning, he confirmed that he created you from a clot, a congealed dead blood, which is a stupid mistake. Repeated again and again in the hadith in the Quran. And this is chapter 96, verse number 15. And here you notice the Muslim, they keep saying to us that the Quran never been changed, but the first verse was given to Muhammad. Today, in the Quran today, is a chapter 96. That means there's no way. Don't call me, Abu Qadir, don't call me. Don't make me block you as before. I give you time. That's it. Chapter 96 is the first verse in the Quran. First chapter, but not today. Today, it is in chapter 96. Who is the one allowed anyone to change the location? If Allah gave it to Muhammad as first, it should stay as first. So this is a clear evidence that the Quran is not what Muhammad he have at his time, at least. Then we will find something. Don't call me Abdul Qadir. I will block you. I will block you. Remember, I blocked you before. Don't do that. Don't be a kid. The squeezing story is stupid. Then Muhammad, he go to his wife and he said to her, and you will notice here, he returned with inspiration, which means whatever he heard from the angel. His neck muscles twitching with terror till he entered upon Khadija and said, cover me, cover me. They covered him with fear was over. And then he said, oh, Khadija, what's wrong with me? You will notice here that the angel of Allah, when he entered to Muhammad, he did not say to him, Assalamu alaikum. And here we ask ourselves a very simple question. Why in this stage Muhammad, God, did not say Assalamu alaikum? Because Assalamu alaikum, it is something Muhammad, he start learning from the Jews when he lived between the Jews. We don't see Assalamu alaikum. If you go to Jerusalem, you will see the Jews saying Salam Alaikum, literally. This is a greeting of the Jews. When the angel came to Mary in the Bible, the angel said to Mary, Shalom unto you, Mary. So the story here have no Salam Alaikum, because Muhammad at this stage, he is not living between the Jews. He did not learn it yet. And then, when he told his wife, what's wrong with me? and you will notice the description that his neck musculars is twitching. This is, it's called a seizure. People who have certain kind of illness, what they call it in English? Tipsy, what they call it in English? Somebody remind me what the name? I forgot the name really. It's like, you know, people, they have a seizure and they fell down on the ground and their muscles shrink, their neck muscles specifically shrink so hard and they get hurt and they start shaking and they feel like as if they are dying. Epilepsy. Thank you. That's exactly what Muhammad is suffering from. This guy, he have a mental issue. And this is based on the description of the Muslim himself and Muhammad himself. And you will notice here Muhammad saying to Khadija, what's wrong with me? Why an angel of God, he visit a man and he told him, I have a message from your Lord. Why he is terrified and why this is happening? And look what happened. Then he told her everything that happened to him and said, I fear something may happen to me. So Muhammad here, he feel that he's going crazy. Khadija said, never, but had the glad tidings. Khadija was sure, Muhammad is not sure. Look at this. Khadija, who did not see the angel, she said to him, no, this is good news. How? She should be worried about her husband. The guy is shaking, going crazy. And she said, no, this is good news. Okay. Then, by Allah, Allah will never disgrace you. Here we notice that Khadija's wife is swearing by Allah. Why Khadija's wife is swearing by Allah? The Muslim, they say that Khadija was a Nasara. A Nasara, according to them, is a Christian. In order for Muhammad to marry Khadija, if she is Nasara, he have to be Nasara too. Nasara for me is nothing but a Christian cult. It is not. It's like Jehovah's Witnesses. It's not really Christian. They are cult. You know, like they believe in Jesus, etc., but in their own wrong way. So here we notice that Khadija, who is Nasara, she told him, come with me. Khadija then accompanied him to her cousin. He is not really her cousin. He is, let us say, like a son of not direct uncle to her. Waraqah ibn Nawfal, Ibn Asad, Ibn Abd-al-Uzza, Ibn Qusayy. Waraqah was the son of her paternal uncle, i.e. her father brother, who during the pre-Islamic period become a Nasara, not a Christian. You see, they say here the word Christian, Nasara. The whole Quran never mentioned the word Christian. They mentioned the word Nasara. And used to write the Arabic writing, and used to write the gospel in Arabic. That is the Quran. And by the way, here we have many problems based on this hadith. If Waraqah was writing the gospel in Arabic, that means there was a gospel, which is non-Arabic, and there is a gospel, which in Arabic. You know what I mean? So where is the gospel which was not Arabic, and where is the gospel which is Arabic now? How the Muslim, they say that the Christians or the Nasara, they corrupted their book. And Waraqah ibn Nawfal is the decent man who made Muhammad a prophet. And by the way, Muhammad, he claimed that Waraqah will be in heaven. So at least at this point, Muhammad, he have a book, which is the book of, it's called the Bible, which is not corrupt. He have two copy of it. He have one in the language which is translating from, and most likely it's Aramaic. And he have the copy which is the gospel in Arabic. Now for me, and this is my own opinion, if you read my book, I have reference proving that Waraqah must be the real father of Muhammad. This is why anytime anything happened to Muhammad, Muhammad, you find him with Waraqah. So to make it simple, when Waraqah died, read with me carefully. It says here, after a few days, Waraqah died and the divine inspiration has also paused for a while. Why Waraqah died? Allah stopped sending messages. I mean, it doesn't make sense. Who is Waraqah? So Muhammad becomes so sad, and we have heard that he intended several times to throw himself from the top of the high mountains. So Muhammad, because of this, there's two things happen, which is destroying his life. Waraqah died, and now there's no Quran. Obviously, Muhammad, he get his Quran from Waraqah. And obviously, Muhammad here was suffering badly, because what he would say to the people, I need Quran. The guy who gave me Quran is gone. And every time he went to the top of the mountain in order to throw himself down, Jibreel would appear before him and say, oh Muhammad, you are indeed Allah's messenger. In truth, whereupon his heart would become quiet, and he would calm down and return home. And whenever the period of the coming of the inspiration used to become long, he would do the same, which means he tried to commit suicide. And here we have to question the stability of the brain of Muhammad. Why each time the inspiration stop or pause, the guy tried to commit suicide? You must be crazy. Why? So what? I'm a prophet of God. I should be wise. God, he sent his message when he wish, as he wish. So why, if he stopped messages, I'm going to go to the top of the mountain and kill myself? And why the angel, he have to repeat the same story? He come to him, he says, you are a prophet, man. Believe me, you are a prophet. Don't do that. That's mean Muhammad, he himself, he don't believe he's a prophet. You know what I mean? In order to do such a thing, that's mean I have to be suffering from mental illness. The angel came to me first time and he said to me, don't do that, you are a prophet. So he confirmed it to me. That's it. Okay, so why I do it again and again and again? It's like a child. Each time he needs some candies, he go to the top of the mountain. He said to mommy, if you don't give me candies, I'm going to throw myself. How this guy can be a prophet of God? So all the story of Muhammad is nothing but a fiction. And obviously Muhammad is suffering from mental illness. Actually, all stories all over the Quran and the Hadith proving that Muhammad is crazy. In the Quran, Muhammad was accused to be crazy 6 times, as I remember. Hello?
Hello, brother. Sorry, I'm so sorry for stopping you, but I have a question there. If the Waraqah writing the Gospels,
sorry?
The Gospels said, sorry for stopping you.
Okay.
So, the Hadith say Waraqah died, and then he stopped writing the Gospel, right? If he wrote the Gospel says Jesus died. Why in Quran we can find Jesus not die?
Okay. Well, this is why, my friend, as I said, this guy is Nasara. He is not a Christian. For the Nasara, he did not die. The Nasara, they believe that the Messiah, he was, because he is son of God, there's no way God, his father, will make him being tortured. So what they believe, that God, he replaced the Messiah on the cross and he made someone look like him, and this is exactly what the Quran is saying.
So Muhammad took from the Nasara.
Yes, he Muhammad, he never met Christians. Muhammad, he have Nasara around him only.
Wow.
There's no Christian around him. He have Nasara. That's why the whole Quran never mentioned anything except Nasara. There's the people of the book in Islam is two, Nasara and Jews. So Nasara is the one he think they are the true Christians, and the Jews, he called them Yahud, which is a wrong name.
Right.
And then and then there is verse like after that, let us say there is like anything have to do with God and prophets, Muhammad obviously is copying from others, but there is a chapters in the Quran is written by Muhammad. This is why they sound very stupid. You see, when if you buy my book, you know, any of my books, and you learn, you know, you read my translation, or let's say that my writing in English, and then you buy Shakespeare, you will notice right away the difference, right? And how strong the language in Shakespeare book, and there is no way to compare my English to Shakespeare, correct?
Yeah.
So if you are an Arab person, right away you will notice that the one who wrote the Quran, there's some chapters they have a good Arabic, and there's a chapters have a very horrible Arabic. It cannot be by the same writer. It's obvious.
Mm.
So I believe that those who they have a good Arabic is what Waraqah he wrote. And the one who have a wrong language is what Muhammad he made. And those are usually the one speaking about any woman, she want to give her private part to Muhammad to sleep with him. Muhammad have fight with his wife. They are silly. They are stupid. So the Quran is divided to what is written by someone who have a good Arabic and someone who have very silly. He have a flight of thoughts. He have suffering from mental illness. He is stupid in the organizing the ideas. His language is bad. His Arabic is bad. And, you know, we have tons of stories. As an example, if you know the story, you know the story where Muhammad is said, Allah is the best of the creators. You remember the story?
Yeah.
Okay, the story is there's a guy, he is an inscribed, he's a Christian. He was working for Muhammad. And some did say he is not a Christian. He is the cousin of Uthman. Anyway, so the guy he was writing for Muhammad Quran. Muhammad was telling him Quran, and then the guy he said, Subhanallah, khairul khaliqin. You know, Allah is the best of the creators. Muhammad he said, write it there.
Yeah.
You know, tabarakallah khaliqin. So the guy he said, but this is what I said. He said, yes, it came to me the same. But he just said that, you know, Muhammad he liked it.
Yeah.
He told him, add it there. He liked it. So the guy here, he decided to leave Islam. And this is what the Muslim says in their books. He went and he said to himself, well, if Muhammad is a prophet, I am a prophet too, because I am the one who said that first. So how does he become Quran? So he discovered that he's a scam. So he ran away and he escaped, and then he wanted to kill him and etc. And you know, he hide in the house of Uthman. Long story. So obviously Muhammad, he made Quran by his own, and he take from people a sentence. As you remember, Umar, he said, my God agree with me in three. Some stories they say Allah agree with Umar in 10. Some they say 7. Whatever it is, you will notice that Muhammad, Umar, he say something. Muhammad, he say, he take it and he put it as it is in the Quran. So we cannot say the Quran is made only from Waraqah, but we can say the major information is coming from Waraqah. And then after that, Muhammad, he have no choice but to make his own Quran. And he start collecting ideas from people around him. But as an example, the Kaaba, to pray to the Kaaba, who is the one who came with this verse? Umar. The hijab, the chapter of the hijab. Who is the one who said that? Umar. You know, so like many things, the verses about Allah threatened the wives of Muhammad to behave, otherwise he will divorce them and replace them by different women. This is from Umar. So Umar, he says something, Muhammad, he take it and he put it in the Quran. And this is the same for anything. There's tons, like a story of Alexander the Great. This is not from Muhammad. Yeah. This is, you know, a legend written by a guy from Syria. And he made a book. It's called The Book of the Two Horn. And the, he called Alexander the Great by the person of the two horn. That's why the Quran mentioned the man of the two horn. Now, if you ask yourself, how Muhammad, he claimed that God is speaking, and then he called a guy, the guy with the two horn. Shouldn't we know his name? Who is this guy, that guy with two horn? Since when we call a person by a horn?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The reason for that, Muhammad is copying a legend, it could be in a story, fiction story. And in the story, it called him the man with the two horn. So in chapter 18, verse number 83, it says, and they are asking you about Dhul-Qurnayn, the man with the two horn. Say, I will tell you a story. And then he starts telling the story, which is a very stupid story, that the guy, he went and he found the sun sitting in the murky water, blah, 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 blah. Here, this Quran, the story is from the guy from Syria who wrote this story about a real person who is Alexander the Great. Like now today, many people write stories about someone is real, but the story itself is fiction, full of fiction. So Muhammad, he took the story, but he wrote it again in his own way in the Quran. So this is the chapter in front of us. This is Muhammad talking.
Yeah,
this is not Waraqah.
So I have one question about the Azar. So when Quran mentioned about the Gospel and Torah, he mentioned about the false story, you know. So it's like there is no Abraham there. It's like just being Abraham and Ibrahim. So where the Muhammad took that?
As I said, everything Muhammad he have is taken from people around him, and for sure, the story about Abraham have two sources here: have the Nasara, because they believe in Abraham, and the Jews. Same as Moses, same as Mary, same as Isa. You know, and here, you know, this is why we see the name is Isa is coming, because he took it obviously from the book of the Nasara, but he could not read it. If you remember, in the Quran did not call the gospel by a Hebrew name. He used the Injil, and the Injil is a Greek word, right? Now here we need to ask ourselves, why Muhammad, he said that Allah, he sent down the Injil. The Muslim, they say to us that Jesus was sent only to the Jews. Okay, how he is sent to the Jews, but yet Allah, he is using a Greek name. Allah is using a wrong name.
No,
you know what I mean. The Injil is a correct name actually, but this is a Greek name. So how Allah, he used the Greek name?
Yeah. I understand what
this is against the teaching of Islam, because if Jesus is a prophet was sent to the Jews, imagine, you know, I am a prophet to the Jews and the name of my book in Japanese. That doesn't make sense. You know what I mean? Why is that? This book is for the Jews, not for the Greek. So he's copying the Greek because this is the only name he knew. He did not learn something else. You know, so he have to put the word as he have it in the translation from Waraqah. You know what I mean? The translation, from Waraqah, he use it. It says Injil, and the same as Azar in the book of Waraqah, it says Azar. So Muhammad do not know what Azar. He put it there Azar, and actually me myself, I believe Muhammad he knew how to write, how to read.
Yeah, I know about that.
But the story when he said, In Arabic, he said, "Ma ana biqari." He was saying what I should read, which is very normal. But the Muslims, they are stubborn. They say they do not know how to read. Why? Because the Quran says that Muhammad was illiterate. But the Quran doesn't say Muhammad is illiterate about writing or reading.
But about the book.
About not having a God, the true God. You know, if you don't have a true God, then you are illiterate. You know, even the Quran says that. I mean, Muslims are really very naive.
About the illiterate, what chapter?
What is what?
About the illiterate.
If you go to chapter 2, verse number 78, as an example, you will see the Quran telling us exactly what is the illiterate. And among them is an illiterate folk who know not, who know the scriptures not, except heresy. Okay? So, as they think. So, who is the illiterate? Is the one who do not know the book. Anyone who don't have a book is illiterate. And the Christian and the Jews are not the... You see... the Quran did not say nowhere that the Christians is illiterate. Always is called people of the book. If read this chapter, example, chapter 3, verse number 20, you will see it says the following. If they argue with you, Muhammad, say, have surrendered my purpose to Allah. So have those who follow me and those who have received the scriptures and those who read not. Do you see it?
Yeah.
This is in Arabic, is illiterate. Read not is so those who receive the scriptures and those who read not. Read not what? Scriptures. So the Quran, you know, divide the people to two kinds of people. The one who is illiterate and the one illiterate about God, don't have a book. And the one who have a book, and this is what the verse in front of us saying clearly. But when you speak to the Muslims, they are stubborn. It says in the front of us, it says they are those who they have a book and those who they are unlearned. Mm-hmm. And this is coming from the Jewish style of teaching. The Jewish believe some, we know that the Jews, we believe in something, or they say Gentile, right?
Yeah.
This is exactly what illiterate mean, unlearned. So there's those who knows God and those the ignorant. We do not know God. As simple as that. It's not about writing and reading.
Yeah.
All right. Anything else, my
friend? It's like the same story with if the Muhammad cannot read and then cannot write, when Muhammad died, he just told his friends to taking material writings.
Right. No, obviously Muhammad, he know how to write, how to read. This is, but I mean, as I said, when I debate with Muslims, I debate him with what they believe in, not what I believe in. I believe Muhammad knows how to write, but as long as they decide to be stubborn and to say no, okay, go with you. That will make it even easier for us to get him busted.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you very much, my friend, for calling. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.